When a good thing goes bad, it's not the end of a world. It's just the end of a world that you had with one girl, and she's the reason it happened, but she's overreacting, and it's all because she don't want things to change. So cry if you need to, but I can't stay to watch you. That's the wrong thing to do. Touch if you need to, but I can't stay to hold you. That's the wrong thing to do. Talk if you need to, but I can't stay to hear you. That's the wrong thing to do. Cause you'll say you love me, and I'll end up lying and say I love you too. But I need someone different, you know it. Oh, you know it all. But I need someone different, you know it. Oh, you know it all, you know it. Something's been missing. Oh, you know it all. Something's been missing. Oh my God. Chris Jones is back with another 2K video. What? Nah. As you can see from the background, this is 2K during Christmas time or near the holiday season. Which goes to show you the last time I played this game. Today's video, the idea of it came about just the other day when me and my old 2K squad, but we still talk every day, but we were just all in a party and we were just down bad. You know, we were down bad. There was nothing to play. And we were just, you know, whatever. We were just sitting there just conversing in a party. You know, because we can't play any games anymore. Well, we can, but, you know. I just put the blame on 2K. In short term. Well, why do I blame 2K? Because, well, for the last... I am 24. Okay. So, when 2K11 came out, when 2K rose to prominence, when it became the game to get, it was 2009. I want to say when 2K10 came out. So I was what in 2009? I was 13. From the age of 13 till about the age of 21, 22, 2K was all I played. Me and my friends had a rotation. 2K, Call of Duty. And that was it. Really, just 2K. 2K was an all-day thing, every day, all day. But as I started getting older, either the game started getting trash, or I just became too old for the game. But somehow, some way, 2K got played less and less and less and less. And now, we are here in 2021. When I am 24, going on the age of 25. And I don't think I'll touch 2K the rest of my 24th year. I don't know what went wrong with this game. I don't know what has happened. But when you have people playing games like Valheim or Valheim, Star Wars Squadrons, FIFA 21, Warzone, Little Nightmares 2, The Medium, I mean, Forza, What's another one here? Forza, Red Dead Redemption, Cyberpunk. These are all games that were bought, thought of being bought, and played because 2K has just lost it. It's bad now. It's lost it. Back in the day, in the heyday, the height of 2K, there was no other game that you bought. You know, no other game that you played. For what? Check up. Get your boys. You see we in Rivet City. You see we in Old Town. You see we in Sunset. Pull up. Get that smoke. You see we in a wreck. What's up? All day. All night. 2v2s, 3v3s, Rec Center, Rival Day, you name it. We was out there. Stage. Now, we play all those games like the list right there. We're trying to find an outlet now. We're trying to find out how to continue gaming, because the reality of the standpoint is, if you're like some of my friends and like me, well, I can't really relate to me because gaming is kind of what I do. So I will find something else to play, even if it aggravates me. But for other ones who 2K was their thing, you may be contemplating right now, do I even need to still play this game anymore? Is my gaming days coming to a halt? Every game that I play sucks now, you know, but 2K is just different. And the reason why I know this 2K in particular is just bad a little bit is just the fact that all the 2K YouTubers, the ones that gain their following off of 2K, they've even dipped off into certain or other areas just to experiment, because the game just different. You know, they'll rather go back to the old gen games. The NBA 2K20, 2K19, which you can't even get on now because the servers are shut down. But 2K20, 2K21, old gen. They'll go back and play that instead of play 2K21 next gen because it's just not that good. And I know there's going to be some people out there that watch this video and be like, well, how can you expect these first wave of next gen games to be good? The system was rushed. The games were rushed. Everything was rushed. COVID came and impacted a lot of work, which is all very true. But my idea is, if it's not done, then postpone it. But I guess they have deadlines because the men in black are telling them this needs to be out on this certain day at this time. And so they released it and it's just hot trash. And well, as of right now, gaming is down bad because of that decision that was made. Now, I do have faith and believe that in the coming years, as the systems optimize more and companies start to focus more on next gen, or well, I should say current gen creations, and start caring more about these current gen systems and start caring less about the old gen systems and games, we may get better product. But then the question arises is it just age? How many of you remember when you were coming up, when you were younger, 6, 7, 8, and you had them older cousins or uncles or brothers, you know, who were, you know, about 5, 6 years older than you, and they, you know, they played games, you know, heavily, right? They played them heavily, and they would always smack you around. They would always beat on you. You know, you couldn't beat them, all of that stuff. Then it got to an 8. Then you fast forward to about 5 years later. Now you're in your, you know, preteens or your early teens, and they're kind of in their 20s. Early 20s, mid 20s, and you start to wax them. You start to wax them in them same games that y'all used to play. And they sitting here like, man, that game sucks now. You couldn't beat me back in the day, blah, 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 all of that stuff, you know, games are garbage now. I don't even play no more. Are we in that stage? Is that where we're at now? Are we at that age where games are just trash now and the younger generation is thriving while we're over here just embarrassing ourselves because the game may actually be the same? It's just that we're older now and our thought process is different and we can tell the difference between a bad game now than we could when we were younger, when we just were so excited that it was something new, a new game to play that you didn't even notice how bad it was. Because, you know, like a lot of people to say the 2K11 is a GOAT game, right? The customization and all that other stuff. But think about how people play the game now and then remaster 2K11 and think how this generation, these people that play now would play that game. You'll grow to hate it. That's why some things are better left in the past than to be remade into the future. Because then the love you have for it would turn into hate. And then you might sit there and be like, man, that game was trash. The only reason why I say that is because I was like that with Modern Warfare. Call of Duty 4, the original Modern Warfare. When they remastered that joint, I started playing it. But instead of being 13 at the time when it came out, or I'm sorry, 11 at the time when it came out, I was 22. That game wasn't that good. Wasn't that good. Didn't play it that much as I thought I would when the remaster came out. But now we're just in a pain situation. How many of you out there have been to your Xbox store, your PlayStation store, just scrolling, looking for deals, looking for games, looking for something to play? Just because your main game that you've been playing for the majority of your life at this point, 2K, has just let you down. It's just let you down. I found outlets, man. I do play a lot of Warzone. Sorry. I do play a lot of Warzone. I do play a lot of FIFA and, you know, Spring and a lot of Madden. Those are my three games now. Those are my three games. And the reason why Madden, if you're wondering, hasn't gotten to me like it has, is just, I don't know. I think I just like that game. I think I just like Madden as a whole, because even with the BS that goes off in Madden, it doesn't really get to me as much as to like Madden. I can go back and play Madden even when the BS happens. It's like 2K is just, I don't know what it is, but I know right now 2K is just at a bad state. And I'll put on my clown mask come this September 2021 and I'll buy it again. But if this year I stop playing in December, at this rate, next year, that December may be pushed up to October, maybe November. And then I'll just be back at it again, creating content with other games and no longer posting any 2K content. I do have a 2K thread. Be sure to check that out. If you see this video and you enjoy, you want to see where things, if you want to see the progression of how 2K went for me, because it's bookmarked. It's there. It's there. It's out there. It started with best builds, best jump shots, to rants, to nothing. There's no video. No videos at all. But right now, I'm in a stage where I'm still content creating, and 2K could be a content that could blow the channel up, but nobody really plays it or cares about it anymore. And YouTube is kind of past the golden stage now. The golden era. YouTube is over. But in the meantime, please, if you would like, go and follow my Twitch. The link will be in the description. Twitch is where I will be streaming almost every single day. My YouTube now is going to turn into a high edit content. So it's going to take some time to get YouTube videos out. I can't spam YouTube videos like I used to, because now I'm going for content or quality over content. Quality over quantity. So if you want to see me play games live and live reactions and unedited kind of raw gameplay, go check out my Twitch. Link will be in the description. But the comment section is open. What is it about 2K now that just makes you play something else? Do you still play 2K? Or do you just be like me and my friends and you just find yourself on every other game every day that's not 2K? I'm interested to know, but this video wasn't gonna pop off as much. But one day, somebody might leave a comment on here. But until next time, and next video, whenever that drops, it's Chris Jones is signing out.